Here we go, folks. Another year of America's pastime. And boy, does 2019 have a chance to be one of the greatest MLB seasons ever. This year, it looks like there'll be more parity than ever before. Superstars like Paul Goldschmidt, Bryce Harper, and Manny Machado change uniforms. The next wave of MLB superstars are about to arrive, led by Toronto Blue Jays' Vladimir Guerrero Jr. And here's the fun thing. All 30 teams have at least a glimmer of hope in winning the World Series. Don't believe us? Well, you better keep watching then. I'm Jason Biondo, and today we present one reason why your favorite MLB team will win the World Series in 2019. Don't forget to subscribe to TPS and put on your notifications because we post videos every single day. Every day is a new video, so you should definitely subscribe. Also, make sure to comment your video ideas down below. We'll be looking, and if we choose your idea, we'll shout you out in the video. So you'll be famous for like 2 seconds. Arizona Diamondbacks, pitching. After losing Paul Goldschmidt and Patrick Corbin, the D-backs show that they're preparing for a rebuild. But guys, this team has the fourth best ERA in 2018 at 3.72. Even without Corbin, the Diamondbacks should be giving opposing lineups trouble. Though he's no longer a Cy Young caliber arm, Zach Greinke is still performing like an ace. And 15 game winner Zach Godley has plenty of room to get better. And the bullpen is still a reliable unit too. You just never know. Great pitching wins championships. If the Diamondbacks' arms do their jobs yet again, it's not all that crazy to think they'll win their second World Series championship in franchise history. Atlanta Braves, the balance. This young star-studded Braves team will be contending for years to come. Winning the NL East in 2018 was just the start for this group. We love the Braves as a World Series contender because of how loaded they are in every aspect. This team scored the fifth most runs in the National League just a year ago. Their team ERA of 3.75 ranks seventh in the majors. Atlanta signed 2015 AL MVP Josh Donaldson to a one-year deal. And bringing back all-star catcher Brian McCann was one of the more genius offseason moves. There's no glaring weakness in this Atlanta team. They can beat you with their arms and their bats. That's why they have to be considered a favorite to win the World Series. Baltimore Orioles. Believe in miracles. That is a great reason. That's like, that is the reason, to be honest, that they can win the World Series. The Orioles were a colossal failure in 2018, losing 115 games, and they won't even have Manny Machado this time around. Well, the good news is that the most amazing miracles can happen when you least expect it. Maybe all these Orioles players endure career seasons and lead the team to a championship. You just need to have faith, Baltimore fans. I love how, like, we don't give an actual reason. We're just like, hey, hope for the best. I'm sorry. I feel so bad. I mean, I guess you never know, but like still, that's just funny. I'm sorry, guys. Boston Red Sox, the core stays together. The Red Sox won the World Series after picking up a whopping 108 regular season wins. Unlike many other recent World Series champions, the Red Sox kept the vast majority of their core together. This team will be one of the premier clubs in 2019, and they're in fine position to defend their title. Mookie Betts, JD Martinez, and Andrew Benintendi ensure that the offense will remain a potent unit. Chris Sale and David Price solidify the rotation as well. The Red Sox won't be topping the 108 wins they set last season, but they have the pieces in place to win their fifth championship since 2004. Chicago White Sox. Young core might be ready. The Chi Sox have one of the best young cores and prospect pools in all of baseball. If the kids are ready for prime time, don't fully discount the White Sox chances of winning a World Series here. You can bet that future all-star Yoan Moncada will be even better after showing flashes in 2018. And would have top prospect Eloy Jimenez is ready to make a huge impact. You just never know. Sometimes a young team arrives much earlier than we think. Could the White Sox be that team in 2019? Don't rule them out. Just have hope. Chicago Cubs, roster balance. The Cubs have endured disappointing playoff exits over the last two seasons, taking away some of their thunder after winning the 2016 World Series. But guys, this is still a championship-level team that will be in the mix this year. The Cubbies had the NL's fourth-best offense in 2019. If Anthony Rizzo and Chris Bryant perform better this year, the entire lineup will be even better. The pitching staff is still as dominant as ever, too. Their 3.65 ERA ranks second in the NL, only behind the Los Angeles Dodgers. The Cubs have to hope that Yu Darvish stays healthy, and that Jose Quintana's second season in the Windy City will be better than the first. Chicago has just enough in their lineup and rotation to contend in 2019. We would not be surprised if they won their second World Series title in 4 years. Cincinnati Reds, the Bats. They're probably the fourth best team in the NL Central, but it's hard to not like this lineup right now. Joey Votto is still performing at an MVP level, with no signs of slowing down either. Scooter Jeanette is among the more underrated power hitters in baseball as well. The Reds also acquired Yasiel Puig and Matt Kemp from the Los Angeles Dodgers in a winter blockbuster. Cincinnati now has one of the best top-to-bottom lineups in the majors. Maybe that's all it will take for them to win a World Series. I mean, who knows? Cleveland Indians, the rotation. Cleveland's lineup certainly isn't as disastrous as 2016 and 17. They relied too much on Francisco Lindor and Jose Ramirez. But the return of Carlos Santana should provide some relief. The bullpen is a concern with Cody Allen and Andrew Miller gone. That said, the Indians still boast one of baseball's best rotations, which is all they need to seriously contend for a title. Corey Kluber is still arguably the best pitcher in the AL. Trevor Bauer is coming off a career season, and Carlos Carrasco is an excellent number 3-4 arm in the rotation. A great rotation is all some teams need to win a championship, and Cleveland has it. Colorado Rockies, runs, runs, and more runs. Every man who's pitched in the Mile High City can tell you how big of a headache it is. Translation: the Colorado Rockies aren't a team that will lean on its pitching to win a World Series. That's just part of playing in Coors Field. The Rockies reached the NLDS after winning the wild card game in 2018, and that was thanks to their lethal bats. Nolan Arenado, Trevor Story, and Charlie Blackmon are among the baseball's most decorated hitters. That won't change in 2019. Ask the 2017 Astros and 2018 Red Sox. You can win a World Series with a dominant lineup, one that can mask some pitching flaws. The Rockies might be able to use that star-studded lineup to win their first World Series here in 2019. Detroit Tigers. Dreams can be made true. The Tigers lost 98 games in 2018, in what was the first year of their major rebuilding project. The front office has wisely cut back on payroll as they try to build up a farm system. But hey, dreams are made to come true. George McFly from Back to the Future once said, "If you set your mind to it, you can accomplish anything." So if the Tigers set their minds to it, maybe they can win a World Series. Houston Astros, experience. The Astros won the World Series in 2017, then followed it up with 101 wins and an ALCS appearance in 2018. Though they were embarrassed by the Red Sox in 5 games, the Astros know they're primed to contend for another championship in 2019 and beyond. The Astros' experience has been key in transforming them into an AL powerhouse. These guys know what it takes to win. The Astros have kept most of their star-studded core together. And with that all-important experience, Houston has the makings to win its second World Series in 3 years. Kansas City Royals. You never know. I mean, I don't think we can be more upfront with that title, so. The core players from the 2015 World Series championship team are long gone, and as a Mets fan, I can say good riddance. Star catcher Salvador Perez is expected to miss the entire 2019 season. Oh, and the Royals lost 104 games last year. Well, the good news for the Royals is that you simply never know when good things will happen. Maybe this rebuilding team suddenly gets hot at the right time. Maybe they add another World Series. Anything is possible. You never know. Los Angeles Angels, the Bats. The Angels didn't do a whole lot to address their problematic pitching staff in this offseason. But hey, the Halos only have the world's greatest baseball player in Mike Trout, and a future Hall of Famer in Albert Pujols. Pujols was plagued by injuries in 2018, but if he stayed healthy, look out. Also, Justin Upton is an underrated power hitter. LA's lineup should be one of baseball's best in 2019, provided everyone's healthy. And for all we know, the Bats will be enough to deliver this team its first World Series since 2002. Los Angeles Dodgers, pitching. Most people might be giving up on the perennial NL heavyweights. The Dodgers just always underperform in the postseason, having now lost back-to-back World Series. Of course, the well-documented struggles of Clayton Kershaw and Kenley Jansen can be cited as key reasons why. The Dodgers had the second-best team ERA in baseball last year at 3.38. It's going to be a top-flight unit again in 2019. The only question is if the likes of Kershaw, Jansen, and Walker Buehler can perform well in the postseason. Maybe 2019 is the year the Dodgers win it all. If that happens, it's simply because their star-studded pitching staff finally came through in October. Miami Marlins. Derek Jeter is a winner. Marlins fans were quite unhappy when Derek Jeter's ownership came in and sold off every quality player they had in such little time. The good news for Marlins fans is that Jeter won 5 World Series championships with the New York Yankees, so at least the team is being run by a proven winner. Come on, Marlins fans, smile. If Jeter can win 5 World Series in New York, why can't he as an owner lead Miami to a championship in 2019? Milwaukee Brewers. Arms, arms, arms. Yes, the likes of Lorenzo Cain, Ryan Braun, and Christian Yelich give Milwaukee one of the best lineups in baseball. But it was really this team's stacked pitching unit that got them within one game of a World Series berth in 2018. The rotation has its question marks, but the bullpen is one of the best in all of baseball. Their manager leaned on in the bid during the postseason, and it carried them to Game 7 of the NLCS. If Milwaukee winds up winning the World Series, it'll be thanks to their pitching. The offense is undoubtedly a formidable group, but the arms will be responsible for taking the Brewers all the way. Minnesota Twins. Revived lineup. The Twins' leaky pitching staff leaves a lot of red flags, but their lineup has a chance to be the best in all of baseball in 2019. Eddie Rosario and Max Kepler are primed for even bigger years after promising 2018 campaigns. But that lineup doesn't stop there. The Twins signed all-star slugger and annual 40 home run threat Nelson Cruz, the ever underrated Ronald Torres, and power hitter Marwin Gonzalez. The Twins are going to provide nightmares for opposing pitchers now. The lineup just has to live up to its potential, plain and simple. If they can do this, the Twins have a chance of bringing the long-suffering Minnesota fans a championship. New York Yankees, a complete team. What is not to love about this team? Led by Aaron Judge and Giancarlo Stanton, the Yankees might have the best top-to-bottom lineup in all of baseball. Top 50 home run threats? Sign us up. The Yankees also have the best bullpen in all of baseball now, at least on paper. Seriously, good luck when you face these guys in the 7th inning and beyond. And rotation? Scary good. The Pinstripes picked up James Paxton and have J.A. Happ for a full year to complement breakout star Luis Severino. There is absolutely no major weakness on this Yankees team. They should be considered the favorites to win the American League. This is the best Pinstripes team in years, and they just might steamroll their way to the World Series, similar to what the Red Sox did last year. New York Mets. Revived pitching staff. Health is key to a bounce back year for the New York Mets in 2019. If Cy Young winner Jacob deGrom and flamethrower Noah Syndergaard both stay healthy, New York might be the best 1-2 punch in baseball. The Mets' top pitchers haven't been able to stay healthy in recent years. If that narrative changes in 2019, this team might win the World Series. They have the pieces to go on a run now. Oakland Athletics, the lineup. Despite a leaky and banged up rotation in 2018, the A's rode a high powered offense to nab the second AL wildcard spot. Five guys hit 20 plus homers, and the Athletics scored 813 runs on the season. Without a doubt, Oakland will lean on their offense to carry the load again in 2019. Chris Davis, Matt Olson, and Matt Chapman all strike fear into opposing pitchers. This is a dangerous lineup that should keep Oakland in playoff contention, and they just might propel this team to a championship. Philadelphia Phillies. Hello, offense, my old friend. The Phillies have assembled an excellent young core that promises to only get better over time. But the Phillies also added one of baseball's premier sluggers in Bryce Harper. The 2015 NL MVP signed a record $330 million contract. So there's your new franchise-changing superstar. On top of that, the Phillies traded for Miami Marlins all-star catcher JT Realmuto. In short, this Philly offense is going to be lethal, and it could be more than enough to help them win a championship. Pittsburgh Pirates. Underdog stories happen. The Pirates are in the midst of a rebuilding process, and the NL Central got significantly better in the offseason. While many folks expect the Pirates to lose well over 90 games, we like to remind you this. The 1980 Miracle on Ice. Joe Namath's New York Jets. Greece at the 2004 Euro Cup. The 2007 New York Giants. Leicester City's 2015-16 squad. You see, underdog teams can sometimes win championships. So who's going to count out the 2019 Pirates? I am. I'm just kidding. Sorry, guys. You never know. San Diego Padres, the Bats. The Padres scored the third fewest runs in 2018, but their lineup is going to be a lot better this time around. Obviously, it starts with the addition of all-star Manny Machado, who signed a $300 million deal. And if Fernando Tatis Jr. is ready for the big leagues, then look out. The Padres will have a three-headed monster in the lineup. Not to mention Will Myers, who's one of the better power hitters in the game. The Padres play in a brutally tough NL West division, but if their lineup lives up to its potential, this franchise could win its first World Series. San Francisco Giants, experience. The Giants don't want to hear it. Too old, too slow, too injury prone, window closed. While some of the key pieces from the 2010, 12, and 14 World Series championship teams still have some juice left in their tank, Brandon Belt, Brandon Crawford, Buster Posey, and Madison Bumgarner will have plenty of baseball left in them. Even Evan Longoria might turn back the clock and rebound with an all-star season if he can stay healthy. Yes, the Giants are old and don't strike fear into other teams like they did a few years back. But if the veterans stay healthy and the Giants sneak into the postseason, well, everybody knows what they are capable of in October. Seattle Mariners. Sometimes rebuilds go well. Even though the Mariners were in playoff contention for most of 2018, the front office decides to strip it all down in the winter. Closer Edwin Diaz, ace pitcher James Paxton, and top hitters Robinson Cano and Gene Segura were all traded away. The Mariners are at least loaded with some great prospects now. And who knows? Sometimes rebuilds in sports take less than a year. Maybe everything comes into place. And just maybe the Mariners shock the world and win the Fall Classic. St. Louis Cardinals, balance. The Cards narrowly missed out on nabbing a wild card berth in 2018, but they're primed for a special 2019 season. They have the 6th best team ERA among NL clubs last year, and they were tied with Atlanta for the 5th most runs scored. The Cardinals, unlike most teams, have a pitching staff and lineup that are both good enough to bring home a championship. The addition addition of all-star slugger Paul Goldschmidt and stud reliever Andrew Miller, will do wonders for this team. Most of the top teams in the NL have a major weakness, but the Cardinals are pretty stacked all over. Could they go from missing the playoffs to win a World Series? Why not? Who knows? There's always hope. Tampa Bay Rays, the pitching staff. The Rays shocked the MLB world with a 90-win season in 2018, thanks in large part to a Cy Young season from pitcher Blake Snell. The Rays finished with the second-best team ERA among all American League clubs in 2018 at 3.74, only behind the Houston Astros. Well, we all know that a great pitching staff can go a long way. The Rays have an excellent rotation and a bullpen that sported a solid 3.80 ERA in 2018. Their lineup has concerns, but if the pitching comes together, the Rays could absolutely win a World Series. Just look at their magical run to the Fall Classic in 2008. It was all about their arms that year. Texas Rangers, the lineup. The Rangers are coming off one of their worst seasons in franchise history. The good news is that it's going to be hard for them to lose 95 games again. The rotation is obviously a mess, but who knows? Maybe this powerful lineup, led by Joey Gallo and Nomar Mazara, will outslug other teams en route to a championship. It's the only hope the Rangers have at winning their first World Series ever in 2019. Toronto Blue Jays, young core arriving. The Blue Jays were awful in 2017 and 18 because they had too many injury-prone and past their prime superstars. Finally, their front office realized it was time to start a youth movement, one that's arriving in 2019. It all starts with Vladimir Guerrero Jr., the top prospect in all of baseball, throw-in catcher Danny Jansen, and another hotshot prospect in Bo Bichette, and the Jays actually might be fun to watch again. And hey, the 2015 Cubs and 2018 Braves made the playoffs much earlier than anybody expected. Maybe the young Jays are ready for prime time and manage to deliver a championship north of the border. You just never know these days. Washington Nationals, the elite rotation. Sure, Bryce Harper is gone, but the Nationals' identity has always been a strong pitching staff. Max Scherzer is arguably the best starting pitcher in baseball right now. And even in his mid-30s, the three-time Cy Young winner hasn't displayed any signs of slowing down. Scherzer is complemented by fellow All-Star pitcher Steven Strasburg, who when healthy is also among the game's elite pitchers. The rich got richer when the Nats signed two-time All-Star Patrick Corbin to an $140 million contract. So now Washington has three potential Cy Young candidates to guide the rotation. Again, losing Harper hurts, but pitching wins championships anyway, and the Nats have it. Do not for a second think about discounting this team. They stand a great chance of re-entering title contention with this three-headed monster in Strasburg, Scherzer, and Corbin. Who do you think will win the 2019 World Series? Join me in the comment section below. Make sure to follow myself and Total Pro Sports on social media. We post great content every single day. Follow us on Instagram, follow TPS on Twitter, subscribe to my YouTube channel. I post videos every single week, so go give it a look, and if you like them, then give me a subscribe. And if you don't, subscribe, because why not? Make sure to subscribe to TPS as well, because we post videos every single day. Every day's a new video, so subscribe. Subscribe. If you like this video, give it a like. It takes one click right down there. Just click it. Just smash that like button. Smash it. Of course, thank you so much for watching. I'm Jason Biondo, and I'll see you next time. My knee.